mutual fund. And in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to dilute a stock juice solution. I originally prepared a juice solution by diluting the concentrate available commercially approximately fourfold. I know the exact volume of the original solution that I used, and I also know the final volume of my solution. Now, this is an estimate that I can find out if I do a search, but the experiment is going to lean towards a Beer's Law experiment later. And so for that, we need to prepare a couple more diluted solutions. So starting with our stock solution and some deionized water. And in this case, I have a little bit more of it here, including a waste container. I will perform four dilutions in a process that we refer to as serial dilution, which means I will be using the same amount of my solution, pour it into the next volumetric flask, fill it up to the marking, homogenize it, and use the same amount over and over again as we perform the serial dilution steps. Because I am measuring the volume of my original stock solution, I will need to use a graduated cylinder. So for these measurements, we will use 35 milliliters of our stock solution. We'll try to remove all the air bubbles, record our volume as accurately as we can. It is 35.1 milliliters. And now we transfer this all into our first empty 50 milliliter volumetric flask. And now we add a small amount of water into the graduated cylinder, rinse it really well, and transfer it over. We do it one more time. And then we set our graduated cylinder to the side. We take our pipette, draw some water, and then make sure that we complete the volume of our solution all the way to the 50 milliliter mark. The meniscus of my solution is exactly at the 50.0 milliliter mark. Now I homogenize my solution. And I am ready for the next step in the dilution. Next, it will be useful if you dry your graduated cylinder in between measurements. So that is what I'm going to do now. Drying ensures that all the volume that you're measuring is associated with your solution and there is no trace of water that would add to your volume. Again, we measure 25 milliliters of our solution. It went a little bit over. It is 35.8 milliliters. Now I will transfer it into my volumetric flask. This is the part where we have to be careful. If we spill the solution, we have to begin again. When we add the water, it's okay if we spill it. It's not as big of a problem because we can always adjust the amount of water at a later time as long as we don't exceed the mark. The meniscus of our solution is at exactly 15 milliliters. We homogenize it. And we are ready to move on to the next step. Again, in between dilutions, it is best practice to dry our graduated cylinders. Now we measure 35 milliliters of our solution. I am very close. It is 34.9 milliliters. Now I will transfer it into my volumetric flask. Then I will add a small amount of deionized water in the graduated cylinder and transfer it over. If I am far from the mark, I can add some more water from the beaker. And as I get closer to the mark, it is best to switch to the pipette. With the meniscus of my solution at exactly 50.0 milliliters, I am ready to homogenize my second to last solution. And now we try our graduated cylinder for our final measurement. Next, we take our final diluted solution and we measure out 35 milliliters. I measured out just a little bit more than necessary at 35.2 milliliters. With this, I will place the cap on my second to last solution and pour the final amount of solute in my last volumetric flask. Then I will add a small amount of water into the graduated cylinder, rinse it thoroughly, transfer it over. And repeat. I am still reasonably far from the mark, and my hand is relatively steady, so I can add a little bit more water. And now that I am very close to the mark, I need to switch to the pipette. The meniscus of my solution is at exactly 50.0 milliliters. And I will perform the last homogenization. And with that, I have five different solutions at different concentrations, all of which contain red dye 40.